Do you have tight ankles, or have you been told that you have tight ankles and they're affecting your Olympic lifts? In this video, I'm going to show you how to open them up, get more force into your lifts, and receive the lift better than you ever have. Hey, it's Drew Dillon from Project Lift, and in this video, we're talking about ankle mobility in the Olympic lifts. Now, I've broken today up into two sections. I got the pre-workout that's going to get you opened up, ready to train, and I have the post-workout deep dig where we're going to get into the ankles even more to help you retain that mobility and range of motion for the long term. If you're watching this video, I imagine you want to get better at your Olympic lifts, so make sure you grab our free guide, How to Improve Your Olympic Lifts, now. You can grab it in this card up here or down in the description below. If the video helps you guys, smash that thumbs up button, pay it forward by sharing it to a friend, and make sure you subscribe because more videos are coming each week. All right, ankle mobility can affect the lifts in a few different ways. Let's just take a quick peek. Now, where we really see the ankles get us are the start position and the depth of the receiving position. Okay, if our ankles are tight, what happens very, very often is our torso has to fold forward because we're not able to bring our hips underneath us as well. So now here comes our torso leaning forward in a way, trying to make up this balance. A lot of athletes who have tight ankles miss forward very often. So we're gonna open this ankle up. And to do that, we're gonna look at pre-workout first. So getting you ready for your training, let's dive right into it. Our very first movement we have is a voodoo wrap with a three-way stretch. So what we're gonna do here is you're gonna take some compression strap. This is historically called voodoo floss because it could open us up in such a way, and there wasn't a ton of research out there of exactly how it was working, but everybody was agreeing that it was working. There's quite a bit more research now if you wanna dig into it, but here's compression strap and here's how we're gonna use it. We're gonna go to our leg, our calf, and we're gonna start about halfway up our calf, and we're gonna start to put this on and we're gonna wrap it down towards our ankle, okay? Now this voodoo floss has to be on tight, so let yourself get this sucker on there nice and tight and go ahead and get set. Now we're gonna get into a classic calf stretch position, right? Against the wall, classic calf stretch, but here's the kicker. We need to keep our foot straight ahead with that toe, and we're gonna keep our heel flat to the ground. Now, once we're in this position, we're gonna drive our hip forward to the right. We're gonna do this 10 times, forward and back, forward and back. Then we're gonna go straight on with the hip, drive it forward and back, then to the left, forward and back. Once we go through all 10 each direction, go ahead and come out of this, take that voodoo floss off, and do a squat, do an air squat. What you're looking for is, does it feel like my knee is able to go over my toe easier, right? That is our test here. Go ahead and do the other side, balance it out. Let's go on to number two. All right, our second movement pre-workout is we're gonna hit the calf and we're gonna do a calf roll. So what we're gonna do with this calf roll, again, love the rollers with the nubs because they're gonna get into something that is gonna surprise you. Rumble roller makes the best, grab one. So we're gonna start with the roller down by the ankle, right? Right where our calf is tying in with our Achilles. At this point, lie your foot over the roller, relax. Our foot movement has quite a bit of say in this roll. So what we're gonna do to start off is we're gonna roll our foot left and right, right? As you find knots, let yourself hold on them and breathe, but then you can rotate the foot at the ankle, and this will do quite a bit to the muscle in the calf to help open it up, okay? After you've done that a few times, you're gonna scoot your butt closer to the roller. That's gonna bring the roller higher up the calf, and repeat, left and right, move the foot around all the way up to the knee. And our third movement pre-workout, we have ankle pails and rails. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna come down to the floor, get our foot flat against the floor, do this barefoot with our knee driving over our toe, but our heel still flat on the ground. What you're gonna do is you're gonna, again, breathe down into the core, start to tense up the whole body as you start to drive the toes and the front of the foot into the ground. Imagine trying to dent the ground as you're driving into this contraction, okay? You have 5 to 10 seconds here. Drive, 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 and then relax, keeping that knee, keeping the tension through the body. Then you're gonna try to lift your toes towards your shin. Again, 5 to 10 seconds. Your toes might come up just a little bit, but you're gonna start to bring them up. Hold, 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 5 to 10 seconds. Repeat this at least 5 times through. Come off. Again, air squat, see how it feels. All right, now let's look at what we can do post-workout to keep this range of motion in our ankles and start opening them up for the long term. So the first movement we have is a calf stretch on a plate with distraction at the ankle created by a band. This is a super simple one. So we're gonna take a plate, we're gonna take a band, hook the band to something that won't move on you. Let that plate be far enough away from you that the band gets a decent stretch pulling on the ankle. We're gonna place the band around the ankle, right? Enough that it's getting a good tug on the ankle without pulling you off the plate or pulling you backwards, okay? Go ahead and get your foot midfoot on the edge of this plate, heel should be down, and let your whole body lean forward. So now we're in this calf stretch position while our ankle's getting pulled by this band, creating a very nice distraction, a very nice calf stretch to start to open things up for the long term. Our second movement is the ankle sit and grind. To do this, we're gonna take a band again and we're gonna put it around something that's not gonna fall on us, not gonna move on us. We're gonna get into the band and we're gonna put the band around our butt. Now this band's gonna hold us up as we sit down into a deep squat. So now the band has us, it's around our butt. I can take my hands and put them around my knee as I shift all my weight over to one side, over to one leg. My foot's flat on the ground, and in this position with now all this weight over the foot, I'm gonna drive my knee forward. If you're thinking of a clock, I want you to think about driving it towards 12 o'clock and then keeping, fighting to keep that heel on the ground. We're gonna bring that knee over to 3, 4 o'clock, then back to neutral and repeat. And here we're doing that same mortar and pestle that I mentioned in the hip video, where we're just using that tib and fib into the ankle to start to open up this area. Let yourself do 5 to 10 grinds through, right? You can stay down here for a minute to 2 minutes. Come out, test, let yourself air squat, see how it feels, repeat with the other side. All right, and the last movement I have for you in this post-workout deep dig is an ankle grind with a plate. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a plate just like we did with the calf stretch. The band, same way, but now we're active in this. So we're going to get that band set to something that won't move, that plate far enough away that we get a good stretch on the ankle, but we're not getting pulled backwards. And now we're gonna step out to the plate, midfoot hits the edge of the plate, heels on the ground, but now instead of leaning forward like we did on the more of a static stretch version, now we're driving the ankle, driving the knee over the toe, going that 12 o'clock, bringing it down to 3 or 4, coming back to neutral. So we're taking that same grind and changing using the band around the ankle with the calf stretch of the plate as we go through this. Go ahead again, guys, do 5 to 10 of these and then come off, go ahead and do an air squat, see how it feels, balance out the other side. All right, so we've seen all this ankle mobility, guys. I wanna know which ones supported you best, which ones felt best for you, as well as let me know, how is mobility affecting your lifts? What's going on? What frustrations do you have? Leave them in the comments below. I want to hear it. Until next week, see you then.